Hey everybody out there in the YouTube universe, Planet Joe 10, out on the 10th planet, out here with an update. First off, just another great week in videos. I want to first off congratulate all the cranky calendar build winners, everybody deserving well, honorable mentions, I mean the whole group, although some of the names I had to look up against their YouTube accounts, but you know, I'm sure that the quality of this year's calendar is going to be spectacular with some awesome builds, so we're going to put our order in for that. And again, congratulations to everybody. I'm sure it's going to be an awesome calendar this year. Also, congratulations to Doc for hitting 10,000 subs. That's a pretty impressive number. You know, he puts on a good show. We all love him. And, you know, I think that pretty much covers that. One good tutorial this week that I've been watching since I'm hinging the 86 Monty here, and it's my first hinging job, is Darren Cooper has been working on a tutorial of hinging, and it's been a really good tutorial. I want to thank Darren for putting that out there. I know he's probably put in a lot of hours to get the video updated and so on and so forth. It's really impressive, and you know, many people have put up hinging videos, which I've watched, and really thanks to everyone, but just happens that Darren's building or hinging this job and creating this video as I'm working on mine, which I do have some questions about, which we'll talk about in the video. Hopefully, you know, everyone in the community might be able to give me some advice. Chevy's group build is going real good. He had a 48-hour build this weekend. It is Sunday night. I think pretty much the build might be over, but I've been watching the update videos. It's been great. A lot of good builds. A lot of fun. You know, snap tight with a twist. I mean, how can you not? It's amazing what people can think of. You know, where your mind can take you when you have a challenge put up against you. I think the group builds are great, and it's a lot of fun to watch the videos. But again, we're going to go over my build updates on the 70 Chevelle, the Monty, and the M7 Priest. Not a lot of building done this week, but a few things. Going to review the Armory by Gauntlett, the Photo Etch Bender. And like I said, I do have some questions in regards to the 86 Monty with the door hinging, and hopefully you guys can help me out with those questions. So let's get to it. All right, guys, just a quick update on the 70 Chevelle. Working on motors right now. This is the motor from the Nova kit, and we have the motor from the Chevelle kit. You know, I know they're both supposed to be 8 cylinders. I honestly don't know the sizes they're supposed to be. That's something I have to find out, but as you can see, the block size, tranny size, you know, there's quite a bit of difference here in size, so I don't know if one is out of scale, or, you know, if they're really, one was supposed to be a big block. Again, I really have to do my research, but these have been glued up, so we'll work on those more as time goes on. We'll just pan down here. Got, you know, this we've already seen. We've got the tub put on the front suspension here, which actually this is dry now, so we can take these off. Had to actually recut and redo the tub, cleaned it up, straightened it out. I noticed when it was on the frame it was a bit crooked, but we've straightened that out. Gotta get some tools to work on that. Again, you know, just a quick mock up here. You know, I had left the suspension holes on this area here for this to be glued in, so this will fit nice. And really just trying to decide if I will use the Nova wheels or for the front, or the Chevelle wheels. Obviously there's a big size difference again, and you know, I don't know if this is a scale issue or what, but I guess we'll see how the stance works out and then go with the wheel size from there. That pretty much covers the chassis, and you know, again, not a heck of a lot done. We did get the body, I did get the body prepped, basically ready for primer. Shaved off all the badges, the hood pins. Like I said, I might go with some Photo Etch hood pins. and just to go along with the little bit of a conversation that's been going on, not that I'm an expert on kits, this kit shows a date release of 2008. I don't know if this, if that's a reef, you know, a re-kit from another year, but you know, the whole talk of AMT and Revell, you know, honestly, I can't speak with a lot of super knowledge, but I can tell you that this Revell kit, for what it's worth, has a lot of flash. It really does. You know, as I've been working on it, you know, I've just noticed quite a bit of flash, and of course this sprue, well, I mean, here's something on the steering wheel. A lot of flash all along the sprues. I don't know how good this will focus, but in general, this is a pretty flashy kit. You know, not super impressive. I mean, you can even see in the corners of the sprue here, you know, just things like this. So, you know, honestly, I'm not bidding in on the AMT versus Revell. I just build what I like, you know what I mean, and I make it work to the best of my ability. But, you know, for a Revell kit, I would say that this is a pretty flashy kit, and not flashy in a good way. The, you know, the AMT kit, I know this Nova kit is a simpler kit too, same thing, quite a bit of flash compared to, I guess, what we might be considered as what we're all used to, but, you know, just something to consider, just in a little bit in that conversation. As far as the M7 Priest goes, you know, we've seen this basically, you know, working on just the howitzer gun itself, got that together, which goes on this bay, and eventually will go inside the tub and so on and so forth. So not really a lot of updates on that, but we're still hacking away at it. Still got our road wheels and so on and so forth. So that's pretty much it for build updates. Gonna do a quick honorable mention there here for my daughter, because she'll get upset if I don't. We had some clay time, my daughter and I. She built her Minecraft dog. I built that thing, Gargantuan, the Gargantuan guy. Actually, though, this modeling clay, to be not so silly, you know, but we might paint him up anyway, actually is good for dioramas and things like that, for rubble, bricks, sandbags. This is just basic clay. And, you know, I had fooled around with it a bit in the past with some dioramas. And, you know, if you take your time and have some patience, you can actually create, you know, some decent diorama parts out of the clay. I mean, they take a... And the great thing about this white clay, it air dries, takes a wash really well, almost just like plaster. So, you know, that's something we're going to use and have used more, and we'll use more in here in the shop. But just a quick tidbit on that. So anyway, that's where I bid on my AMT versus Revell. That's our update for what we're building, and we'll move on to the next part. Alright guys, we're going to do a quick Photo Etch review of this Photo Etch Bender called the Armory by Gauntlett, which I showed you guys a couple of weeks ago in a previous video, distributed by M&M Models. I guess that's their information. Also, a quick tip. A lot of guys with Photo Etch, you know, in modeling in general, as we know, you cut off a piece off the sprue, the piece goes flying, you know, and you're searching in the carpet for the rest of the month. Now, in Photo Etch, pieces are extremely small. Those things on the right are little hex nuts, just to give you an idea. I know this isn't going to be the clearest, but just to give you an idea of the size, they're tiny. So some guys will use tape, blue painter's tape, and stick the Photo Etch fret onto the tape. You know, if this was the tape, stick it on, do their cuts, which works well. You know, the thing is, sticking it, unsticking it, some of the pieces tend to bend or get stuck to the tape. It's not a bad idea. The other way you can do it is using just your basic sandwich bag, okay? And, you know, placing your Photo Etch piece in the sandwich bag. Finding the piece you wish to cut. I'm going to cut something a little bit bigger just for
demonstration purposes, but you know, find what you need to cut out. Always using an extremely sharp blade, and the piece may go flying, but as you guys might be able to see, it did fly on top of the fret. I pull the fret out, and there is my piece. Now, again, this works really well when doing extremely small parts. That way the piece hopefully remains in the bag, doesn't fly out to the no man's land, I guess you could call it, and you know, anything like that is good. So quickly though, again, we talked about this a couple of weeks ago. I picked it up at my local hobby shop. It is made out of plastic, it's not metal. I had paid $18.99. The metal ones I do, you know, obviously do offer a lot of, a little bit more durability, I think, but you know, photo etch is so fragile to begin with. As you can see, these photo etch pieces have the bends, lines as to where your bends are going to go, as most of them do, and we'll go ahead and give it a test. One thing I will say about this is I do like the base. It has rubber feet, keeps it really sturdy to the, you know, as you put some pressure on it, really sturdy to the bench. And we basically, you know, I'm sure some of you guys have used this. I'm doing a bigger piece just for demonstration purposes. But again, there are a lot of pieces you can do, smaller pieces and so on. And I'm hitting something here. 1 minute. Let's see. So we may actually not be able to do this piece, which already poses a problem. So we will fold here and figure out a way to do the bigger pieces. So already a limitation of this is the fact that we can't really bend that the way we want to. So that's interesting. So we will try using this side. And again, if you guys are watching this, this is the first time I'm using it as well. But we will try to line this up. Apologize. So the idea again is to tighten this down. And do your bend. So already I'm seeing limitations with these two handles here. Now I realize this is a big piece, you know, probably could be bent with, again, pliers, which is how I've done it in the past, but the idea of the photo etch bender is to be able to bend these types of parts. And you know, I honestly hate to say this, but you know, this isn't gonna work. As you can see, or as you may not be able to see, the score line is way over here. I mean, I can't even go to the end without that. So I'm not really impressed so far. For smaller pieces, you know, such as these boxes here, these are ammo holders, boxes, I think it'll be fine. But for these bigger fender pieces and so on, not so much. So that's unfortunate. Again, you guys are seeing it as it's happening, as I have yet to try it as well. So that's really kind of a bummer, to be honest. You know, again, for the thinner pieces, it seems to be okay. Actually, we'll bend this piece next. Yeah, again, I'm hitting it again. And when I put it to this end here, I can easily move that, really, unless I'm in between these two cleats, You know, and that's with it down pretty well. Well, okay. So that's not too impressive. We'll play with it some more, go online, and see what we think. But so far, not very impressed with the Photo Etch Bender. Again, the plastic bag trick hopefully, you know, helps a few guys who may not have done Photo Etch in the past. And we'll move on. A little disappointed. Okay, guys, so the last part of this is just a quick question for all you skilled door cutters out there. Although I was able to bend this really easily with my hand, it's, you know, still needs to be glued together and all. But honestly, the jury's out on the Armory by Gauntlett. So far, not impressed. And actually, just to finish this quickly, you can actually see, even when this thing is secured, it's kind of... It's kind of wonky, I guess. It's just not going in the way we want it to. You know, it looks like it's cross-threaded, but I'm taking it all the way out. But we'll deal with that another day. So, for all you car door openers, again, as you know, this is the 86 Monte Carlo, and it would be my first attempt. However, I've noticed that the Monte Carlos did not use the door frame this way. The window, you know, went against a rubber, just against the rubber, whatever you want to call it, gasket. So, to cut this door, I would need to cut here along this line, as we all know. And also, you can see I've started to cut it right on the pillar. Now, the problem with this is that this pillar, if I cut through this pillar, it's going to dangle. So I guess my question to some of you door openers is this just not a door open type of car? You know, I guess the pillar might hang on by a thread here at this junction where it meets, but anybody who's experienced with that, you know, obviously somebody might have a great idea that I haven't thought of. Obviously, maybe adding some styrene in the back to strengthen up the pillar once the door is cut off. I don't know. Any recommendations that you guys might have, or if some of you just feel that some doors weren't just made to be cut. I mean, I'm sure, obviously, if you put your mind to it, anything can be done. But for my first door cutting, am I maybe biting off more than I can chew? Like I said, I might be able to glue some styrene in here to the front, to this pillar, but I really don't know. So, you know, hopefully some of you guys will look at this that have cut doors and maybe able to give me some advice. Maybe just say, you know what, for your first door cutting, can it and use something else, and I'll just finish the model. Honestly, I don't want to become so disappointed in door cutting that I don't reattempt it. So, that's a question for you guys out there in the community. Hopefully if you guys could comment, I would greatly appreciate it. And we'll just finish up with a few final thoughts.
All right, guys, that pretty much wraps it up for this week. You know, again, more of a quick review tutorial type video. I hope you guys enjoyed what you saw. I hope that, you know, hopefully some guys can get back to me in regards to the 86 Monte as far as to cut or not to cut. I look forward to any feedback that anyone has to offer on that. Not too happy with the Gauntlett by Armory, which the piece just fell on the floor, where maybe it belongs after what we've witnessed today. But we'll play around with it some more, see if there's something I'm missing. Overall, not too happy with that. And we will continue on with our build updates. Again, congratulations to everybody who made the cranky calendar. I look forward to seeing you guys on the calendar and in the calendar and reading all about it, hanging on my wall. And we'll catch you next time. See you guys.